is similar about ancient Rome compared to nowadays. The marriage rite was something that was celebrated, and indeed elements of it in the Christian religion today still mimic those from Roman times, for example, the exchange of rings. That is a Roman slave collar. That's literally being put around someone's neck and they're forced to wear it for the rest of their lives. And on it, because we can translate the Latin, it says, if you find this man, return him to Zaninos, that's the name of the owner, I will give you a gold coin.
Today we had two talks. The first one was for year 10, so GCSE students of Latin and classics, and that focused on everyday life in Rome and Pompeii and other Roman cities, giving a flavour of how similar but also how different life might have been like back then.
These are formal portraits, and the women are holding a pen, a stylus, in front of their lips. 2,000 years ago, what that showed you looking at it was that woman can read and write.
Ben, I've seen Ben speak before. He's a fantastic speaker on classical topics. He's an author, essentially now, of military and historical fiction. He does a lot of his own research himself, gets involved with reenactors as well, in particular of the Roman military, written over 15 novels.
Remember that every Roman was only about 5'6", that's 1.65 metres. So if I drop down a few inches, put a helmet on, and I come at you like this, with a much bigger shield, you can see that lack of armour was actually potentially not that bad.
We just had a talk from Ben Kane about what Roman life was like during the Roman Empire. He's given us lots of cool facts about lots of different things that they did.
I liked how he linked the past to the present. I did try on a suit of armour, it was very, very heavy, but I could see how it kind of worked. You kind of just hold the shield and like stab around it. It's quite easy to use, actually. Yeah, I did look quite stylish with it on, I think, so.
One of the things that I learned was that their toilets were like all together and they didn't have any stools and stuff. They were all, you could see people doing it and it was kind of disgusting.
A Roman surgeon could set a broken limb pretty well. They could amputate your limb very successfully in the Roman army and stop you from dying. But if you had anything sort of from here to here, or something wrong with your eyes, you know, you either got better or you didn't.
We like learned about all of our like bad hygiene and how that would affect you then. So like if you got sick now and you needed antibiotics, you couldn't get them and you just have to either get better or die. And they could like amputate legs.
We had the whole of year 9 come in for the second talk today. A number of them are studying Latin and classics already, but quite a few won't be. All of them have the option to take classics at GCSE, and I was hoping that that talk would be really interesting and inspirational, I suppose, for anybody, whether or not they want to study the subject at school.
Today has been really useful, actually, because we are currently studying Roman city life and all of that, and that's linked in quite nicely with what we're doing. I've definitely learned some new facts from what he's been saying to us today, so it's been really good.
I study Latin, which is sort of similar to classics but more about the language, and lots of the sort of stories we translate and based off mainly the Romans' life. So having, I think, talk today is really helpful to sort of help learn what we're actually translating and see how it sort of links with the context a bit better than just sort of reading a story and translating. You can understand why someone's written it or what they were sort of thinking at the time, which I think is really useful.
I think some people see Latin and classics as old, sort of dusty, fusty sort of subject that's based in books and museums, and a lot of it is, but actually what Ben has showed us today and what I hope that these talks have done, but also the trips that we run to museums, to plays, and also to sites overseas and in the country, what I hope all of that does is to bring the whole subject to life and show how interesting it can be and how many ways into these topics you can find.